Hey guys, this is Target. Right now, again, you're not watching the next match. What you're actually looking at right now is just some random stuff. I actually wanted to show you a demo of, well, kind of just my Google Chrome. I was going to show you guys some things, but apparently Fraps doesn't want to work outside of a game. So you're just going to have to listen to my voice and watch whatever's going on in the background. There's not going to be any sound because that's going to kind of distract from my beautiful voice. I just want to go over the teams really quick before I got started. For you guys that don't know, there is an upcoming cup with five teams in it, four players per team. So I'm just going to go over the teams really quick. That's the purpose of this little intro, and then I'm going to jump right into the first game. So the first team, all the teams are, I guess the top player with an exclamation mark. So Team T exclamation mark actually has T exclamation mark on it. That's his name. You also may know him as Twitch. He's been playing extremely long time, as long as I remember anyway. He's gone on leaves as well as I have. Back in the day, he used to use the name TX exclamation mark. He's on a couple of different clans. I don't remember all of them. Then he kind of took a little bit of a leave, came back as the name Twitch. Nobody really knew who he was because he never ever talked. Basically came back and destroyed everybody. In my opinion, he's one of the best players to ever play. Very good defensive player. So very good player on that team. Second person on that team is Bonkers. You'll remember him from a lot of my other videos, a couple of my other videos anyway. In the last tournament, he was a little bit underrated, I think, on Neox and Sabotage's team, or Quasi, I don't remember what name he went by. He ended up being, one of the all-star players of that cup and helped bring his team to, I don't know, tied for first place. That never ever got determined, but very good player. So him and T together, he's pretty good offense. T's pretty good defense. It's going to be pretty hard to beat. The other two players on the team, Rust, used to be on a clan RD. They were very popular Red Dragons back in the day. I don't know, the last time I seen Rust play is probably about 10 years ago, 8 to 10 years ago. Just came back, maybe a month or so ago. And so it's interesting to see some of these older players come back to start playing again. I think he's kind of a lot rusty right now, but I think if he stays at it, he's going to be a very big force to be reckoned with. He has been hitting a lot of his rails and stuff. I think he's going to be kind of the determining factor for this team right now. And then the fourth player on the team is Yauza. He's the guy that sponsors the whole thing. Yauza recently talked to me, said that he hasn't been playing as much as he wants to. He's in a very busy season with his work, and so he hasn't been on the servers as much as he would like. You'll remember him from the last cup as well. He was on Hops's team, him and Bones. Very underrated player, I think. He did really well in the last cup. But if he hasn't been in the swing of things, he might even be, that weakest link, I guess, in this team. Very good all-around team. I think this team is going to go far. Next team I'm going to go to is N exclamation mark. Main player on that team is Neox OTB. For you, those of you, watched the last tournament, I guess. He did very well. He's probably the second best player, obviously, in this cup. Very strong offensive player, very strong defensive player, and very good on the quad. Very good all-around player, let's say. Second player on that team is myself, Target. I would say that, I'm also kind of a very good all-around player. Definitely not as good as Neox, but I play well on defense when I need to, or I play well on offense. Typically, I'm mostly put on offense because, honestly, there's not many people that are very good at offense. A lot of people are better at defense, especially in this cup. The good thing about this is that me and Neox could swap out if I'm having a hard time on offense, maybe pop him on offense or vice versa. So we'll see how that plays out. The next player is Gamma. You'll remember him from the first cup. He was very good offensively in the first cup. We played a few pickups here lately, and man, that guy's gotten a lot better from that first cup. Hitting a lot more of his rails, just a lot better all-around player. So it's good to have him on my team. And fourth player is Barton. I don't really know who this guy is. I guess he's a team deathmatch player. So that should give him the basic fundamentals of how to play Quake. What I mean by that is, you're killing a lot of people, so he'll have that. The problem that I have, or well, that I have, that a lot of people have coming from team deathmatch or Rocket Arena, is that they don't really understand particulars about CTF. I find a lot of the times they just try and kill people, where that's good in a lot of ways. Capturing the flag is what really matters, and a lot of them For instance, I've seen people that come from Rocket Arena and they will attack the enemy base with 30 health and the power amplifier. Well, basically all you're doing there is, you know, unless you can kill the other team, which is very rare, you're just giving the power amplifier to the other team, and it's going to make you that much harder to attack the next time. A lot of the times, if you have the power amplifier, bring it back to base, give it to your own defense, and then go back to do an offense. So it's just simple things like that that maybe Barton won't know, that hopefully we can get him into gear before too many matches go underway. The next team is S! Led by Stan. Stan is another good all-around player. Very good at offense when he needs to be, very good at defense when he needs to be, and good on quad. Him and I, you know, who's better, who's worse, I don't know. I would probably lean towards him as a better all-around player. He's, I don't think, near as good as Neox, but who knows? It, you know, one person has a different opinion than everybody else. So what I will say is that, like I said, he's a very good all-around player. He's been playing this game for a long time. He's been in lots of pickups, so he definitely knows the game. Next player, Al Pacino. I would have said that, you know, he's not a very good player, especially based on his performance from the last cup. I know that he used to play a lot, used to run the clan Legends, I believe it was. You know, was very good back then. He came back that first, you know, that first cup that we had there. Wasn't that good, I would say. Missing a lot of his shots. You know, me and Legend played 2v2, him and Gamma, and we just destroyed them. But between now and then, I can't even tell you how much better his rail has got. He's been hitting so many rail shots. It's very impressive. Next person on the team is Dash. Dash is somebody I didn't really know much about. I guess he used to play off and on throughout the years. I guess I don't really ever remember playing with him that much. You know, a couple of his aliases kind of seem familiar, but he's been playing with us a lot lately. Been on vent, kind of talking to us. You know, he's a very good player. His rail is getting there. His grappling is getting there. I haven't been playing, I guess, as much as everybody else. Everybody else is raving about this guy, so, you know, it's going to be interesting to see how he makes out in this tournament. And last position is Yoda. You'll remember him from my last video. He ended up joining mine and Legends team. Again, this is another player that I didn't really play with that much up until very recently, up until, I guess, the last cup. I think he did really well in the last cup, all things considering. Like, I don't think he played in a lot of pickups and stuff like that, or a lot of team games, so very impressed by how he did in that last cup. Hopefully he'll be able to kind of bring this team together. Next team is L with an exclamation mark, led by Legend. If you don't know who Legend is, you probably haven't been playing this game. He's been playing forever. He's always on and around. One of the best offensive players, I would say, in this cup. I'd say maybe Neox is probably the better grappler, making Legend maybe second place grappler. Very good on quad. Doesn't play defense a lot, but if he needs to, he's good at a pinch. I think he's just a very good all-around player. Next person on the team is Cake. Cake's very much known for playing defensive, having a very solid rail, and not being a squirmy defensive player, I guess, like other players possibly are. You know, when you run into base chaining, he usually holds his ground and rails you in the face. Not so much known for his ability with quad maps. He's actually very adamant about not playing quad maps for the most part. I guess he just doesn't like them. And on the offensive, I've seen him run offense before. I'm not going to say he's bad at offense. It's just something he's not very well known for. Next player on the team is Elka. Elka has a very solid rail. That's mostly what he's known for, is just standing around a base and railing people. People said that I kind of underrated him in different polls on the forum because of the fact that I just don't think his grappling ability is all there, and I don't really think that his quad control is possibly there. But that being said, he's going to be a very good assist, I guess, coming towards Legend. You know, if Legend's the best player on the team, he's going for quad, then Elka is definitely going to be there to back him up. So next player on the team is Fours. Fours, again, has been playing, you know, maybe not as long as some of these other guys, but for a very long time. He's been on Ven with us. He's played in many, many, many pickups. He definitely understands what he's doing in Quake. You know, he's not one of those people that you really need to coach on what to do. You just give him the job at the first of the game, and he's going to do it. The only thing I noticed about Fours in the past is that he plays very dependent on how his team plays, I guess you would say. What I mean by that is if his team's playing really well and winning, you'll never kill Fours. If his team's doing bad or a bit behind, he'll just walk in a rocket. It's kind of weird a little bit. If you watch my last demo, we were playing against, you know, it was me and Legend and Yoda playing against Fours, Cleaner, and Stan. And there's a lot of times where Fours just I don't know. It's like he couldn't make traction certain times. His team's a bit behind, and he just couldn't find traction. That's the only negative thing I have to say about the guy. Otherwise, he's a very good all-around player. This team is actually slated to be the best team. There's a poll in the forums, and I don't know how many votes there was, maybe 12 votes, and 8 of them went to these guys. So I think it was over 50% of the people thought this team was going to win the cup. Last team is Team R exclamation mark, led by Rusty. He's an off and on again player like myself. He's been playing a very long time, and then he quits and then comes back. Again, another person that plays most positions very well, plays defense if he has to, plays offense if he has to, and can get on quad if he has to. It used to be a point in time where I thought we played very similar. I'm not sure if we still do, who's better, who's worse. We're very close in that skill range, I guess. I think he kind of felt that he got a little bit overrated in this tournament, being the leader of his team, possibly the worst out of the five players. Who's to say? I'm not the person to say, I guess. Next person on the team is KSMB. He's a Euro guy. I believe he moved to North America now. He used to run all the Euro Cups over in Europe, I guess, and a very, very solid player over there. He came to North America, and again, he's a solid player. He understands the fundamentals about Quake, how to get quad, who to drop power shield to, when to drop cells, when to play offensive, when to play defensive, and he's got a killer rail as well. I'd say, out of all the railers in this thing, T's probably the best, or Twitch. Elk is probably, a very close second. After that, it's a good mix-up between Al Pacino, Cake, KSMB, and maybe even Stan. All those people have like a really good rail. Even Legend, sometimes has an amazing rail. So everybody has kind of the ability to rail. I find KSMB, you usually find him in base railing, and that's what he's known for. But on quad maps, you will see him running around helping out the quad as well. Next player on the team is Blackberry. Blackberry is one of the guys I like to joke about because used to be when we would play pickups, he'd be on the other team. And he would walk all over me. I couldn't get anywhere around the map without him hitting me in the face. And so the next map, I'd be the captain. I'd say, Blackberry, get on my team. And I'd double his score. Like, he would just fall apart when he was on my team. I don't know what it was. Again, a lot of people, when we both used to play very consistently, used to, rank him right there with me. He's been off for a long period of time. He's also got, his wife's got a bun in the oven, I guess. So he's expecting a baby any day now. So. Good luck with that, or congratulations, I guess, if it's already happened by the time this gets uploaded. But again, another very good all-around player. Last person on the team is X. X is also another person that is known for staying in base and railing a lot. I would say out of all the people on this team, he has the least fundamentals, I guess, of Quake. He kind of runs to his own clock, I guess to say. What I mean by that is there's been certain times where I'm on the red team, our team has a flag, they're bringing it home to go for a cap. I die, I end up in the blue base, I go in to kind of wait to grab the blue flag when it respawns after we cap, and X is there kind of waiting and railing at me, and he's not kind of going to kill our flag carrier. So sometimes I find that he can be out of position possibly. Also, in other times, I'll come into base, I'll shoot a couple rockets, and I'll get him kind of off balance a little bit, and then I can grab the flag and get out of base without him maybe being able to hit me. Just because, you get him off balance a little bit, and then you get him on the back foot, and he doesn't play as well, possibly. That's all the teams. My predictions for the whole thing was, well, I'm not going to go into my predictions. I'm just going to go by the forum. Predictions. Legend's team was ranked, like I said, 50% chance to win. T's team was ranked 20% chance to win with 3 votes. Stan's team had 2 votes to win, and then Neox's team and Rusty's team both had 1 vote. So that's what the forum thinks is going to happen. We're actually going to watch the very first map between T's team and Legend's team. So that's the demo I'm going to be playing. That's going to start. All right, guys, so here we go. We got 10 seconds to go. I think I've already gone over the teams enough already. I believe the person recording this is going to be Dash. I don't know that he's, yeah, I went over him. He is on one of the teams. So it looks like we start with Legend getting quad, getting haste. Gotta watch out for this red player. Nice rocket. Y, I guess, is Yowza. So Legend's going into the water. He's got to be careful here. He does have haste, but he does not have any armor, so. Shot's gonna take him out. Looks like he's spawning in the red base. He's maybe gonna attack at this point. It looks like he got killed by T, which is Twitch. Twitch loves the haste, and so I wouldn't be surprised if he has haste. It looks like Dash is just kind of wandering around trying to find out who has a flag. Looks like whoever had the flag died. We were following Elka at this point. He's got amp. Doesn't have any armor. Only has about half health. Got to be a little bit careful here. I think he's waiting for Quad to spawn. Looks like Rusty has the flag for the opposite team. Gets railed. Nice rail by Elka. But he's maybe going to go down 2 health left. I think if the person with the Hyper Blaster knew he only had 2 health, they would have finished that job off. However, they went the other direction. Good thing for Elka. So, tech swap here. A little bit crazy period in this point where Elka's not at full health. You know, one shot's still going to kill him. So he needs to maybe grab some armor and let that fill up. Looks like Rusty was able to grab Quad here, but doesn't have any health or armor. Looks like he was going to try and attack enemy base and gets railed by 4, so nothing so far. 1 minute into play. These are 15-minute matches. Looks like Legend grabbed the flag, somehow got out of base, wasn't paying attention to what happened there, and was able to cap the flag. So, good job on Legend's part. 1-0 for the blue team. So far so good for the blue team. B is B. Not really sure who that is. Burton's on my team. I know he's not playing. Blackberry has a flag and is going towards the water. I hate with all these aliases. It's very hard to keep track of who is who. I'm going to try and do my best here, guys. Looks like Blackberry still has a flag. Has Doc. Looks like... Whoa! Elka comes to the rescue and takes him down. But there's a couple red players on the blue flag carrier and take him out as well. So... So the techs are still down at Red Rocket Launcher. Looks like Legend was able to pick up Doc. Ate a rocket there, possibly, but not going to kill him. He's, like I said, he's got Doc here. As long as his team can return the flag, he's not in any danger of dying here right away, unless the other team gets Quad, attacks him Quad. It's going to be very hard to kill Legend when he has Doc. A little bit of rocket jumping. Nothing too bad. Looks like Twitch has the flag for the other team. Possibly the other Quad carrier for the opposite team, so I'm not really sure who's going to be going for Quad, who's not going to be going for Quad. Not really sure who has it. I don't see anybody like chaining or super shotgunning mostly in the console. It's just railing. Following Twitch at this point, he's got Disruptor Shield, so again, he's not in any hurry of dying either. Full health, mostly full armor. You know, he could get 5 more armor if he runs down and grabs that armor. But he doesn't do so, so looks like he just picked it up. Possibly blue Quad. Maybe he's trying to hide from Quad a little bit at this point. Grabbing those extra rockets. Blue flag. Blue player grappling around. Twitch is able to kill him. Possibly letting his team know that Haste is at that position. Following Blackberry at this point. Nice rocket. Gets taken out by Legend. Was that Yowza killing the enemy flag carrier there? Was able to take out Autodoc, so good job by him. Following 4s at this point. Red Quad, looks like it's Rusty. He's got the machine gun. Looks like Twitch is playing a little bit of D. Legend still has the flag. He must have picked that up again. Looks like that was him going there. And so he's got one red player chasing him. Looks like most of the blue players are trying to attack the red base here. Not sure where the flag here. There he is. It sounds like Twitch has Doc. He does have Doc. Need a rail there. I was going to watch out. It looks like Elko is railing at him. Elko goes down, but it looks like he's got another red player there kind of helping him on defense. So I think he's just waiting on his team maybe to get Quad, kill the enemy flag carrier, and return the flag at this point. Looks like he's just kind of hanging out in D with the Doc. Looks like Blue Quad. Maybe has to be a little bit careful here. Looks like Cake has it. I've seen Cake super shotgun a couple people. 2 blue players coming in. Got to be really careful now. Eats a couple super shotguns. Down, very low on health, and he is taken out by Cake. So down he goes. And that's 2-0 for the blue team. Off to a very good lead. Nice railing there by Rusty, it looks like. Was able to take out the enemy quad and get Doc back, so good job on his part to do that. His flag is missing from base. Looks like a late second return by Twitch. Was able to return that flag. Looks like Elka has Amp here. Very low on health. Has to be a little bit careful. Trying to just spam some rockets, do some damage. Is able to take out the disruptor shield. Only has 3 rockets left. Nice rockets there, though. Is able to kill the enemy. I think his armor is up. He should maybe be going for that at this point. Nice rail. Should still maybe be going for that. Does decide to go and grab it. Now he will survive, you know, that one hit. He's going to be very low if he does get hit, but he'll... Whoa, there he takes a hit right away, down to 22 health. Decides he's going to chain, but no dice. The enemy team is there and takes him out. So it looks like Blackberry took the flag. He's only got disruptor shield at this point, 35 health. One rail will kill him at this point. A couple health packs up. If he goes and grabs him, no. Decides instead to go for Mega. Good choice, I guess. Looks like he was back in base just as the enemy was taking his flag. Grabs armor, he's still very low. His teammate's able to return the flag though, and he's able to get a point back. Nice rail, he's able to take out Doc, but is killed instantly. So now he's respawning, trying to go through middle. I'm not sure if Quad's up, where's Quad's at? I haven't heard or seen anything from that. Looks like Twitch is on defense, one hit point, but he's able to use it to play some defense. His teammate is taken out with the flag, but he's able to kill the person who went to return the flag. Quad came in, got suppressed, and his team is able to get the cap. So good job. Back down to one health again. And he rails Quad because why not? One health. Might as well just kill everybody. So playing defense with one health. I think if anybody against him knew, you know, they would blaster him or anything. Somebody's trying to super shotgun him. Somehow he survives that. Yelza helps him out with a grenade to the face, and they're able to get another cap. So 8 minutes left to play. 3-2 for the red team. So considering they were down 2-0, good job on the red team to kind of get some caps back here. So
the enemy's flag is in your possession.
Looks like Blackberry has the flag, the blue flag. Not sure where he's at this point. Looks like maybe Quad is up soon. It does come up. Elka gets it, eats a rocket, but still has a little bit of health left. Looks like he's gonna use it for defense at this point. Doesn't have any techs or anything, so it'd be maybe a little bit unwise to attack enemy base. Catches somebody in the water, but is not able to kill them. Sounds like that person just got Mega, so they would be a little bit harder than normal to take out. Is able to kill Disruptor Shield again. I guess his teammate possibly took Disruptor Shield, so again, doesn't have anything to speak of. Doesn't even have full health and only 50 armor, so looks like maybe Elka's playing a little bit of defense at this point. Going to be watching for, you know, which way they come. This is a very tricky map because if you try and watch the hallway, somebody can grab Mega and come in through the water and escape through water. If you try and watch water, somebody can come in from the railgun and catch you in the water. Sometimes it's easy to get stuck in the water. Looks like Elka grabbed haste, has chain gun out, put in a lot of damage to that player. I'm wondering if they have maybe Doc. I think he may have even railed them once. Does have Doc. Not that low though. You would expect them to be a little bit lower with all that chain that he took. Possibly grabbed an armor on the way. Decided to go towards his quad. That might be a smart move. Grabs Mega on the way. And so unless the other team is able to grab the flag here, there's going to be a cap. And this is what I mean about getting stuck in the water, guys. Took him a few extra attempts just to get out of there. So sometimes if you go for your own Mega, you can get stuck in the water and the person can go out the hallway before you can even get out. So a little bit tricky, but and a little bit risky, honestly, if you're a defense player. Red's just getting cap after cap here. I think that's, what, 4 caps in the last 2 minutes. So I'm not sure if that's Blue's defense falling apart, or honestly, I have no idea what it is. Nothing from my perspective that really shows anything. I mean, Blackberry did have Doc, so he was able to eat a couple extra shots there. I have to think that possibly the red team's playing maybe a better defense at this point, which wouldn't surprise me right now if Twitch is on defense. Nice rail by Force, it looks like, takes out Twitch and the Amp. It doesn't matter. Twitch respawns, grabs armor and the mega health. And I guess this is Rusty. He's there defending base. So good job on the, by the red team to kind of keep defense alive. And that's kind of, I think, a major part of why they're doing so well this map. Looks like Rusty's attacking now. Doesn't have any tech, so there's nothing that he's really going to lose. Looks like Elk is trying to chain him down, possibly. Doesn't work out too well for him. He gets taken out, and Rusty's able to grab the disruptor shield. I think he's maybe trying to switch to the rocket launcher and then realizes that he doesn't have any rockets left, so lag. Maybe that's Legend, I'm not sure. Takes him out, so... whoever it is, nice rail. His teammate gets taken out, but it doesn't matter. He's able to take him out. I'm better in base. I wonder if that was... I think that was Yowza that said that. Why exclamation mark. I believe he's on Twitch's team. The red team, sorry. And so it looks like we're at a little bit of a lull. We got, you know, four caps in 2 minutes, and then the next 2 minutes nothing happened. So looks like we got Elka playing D some more. Looks like blue team had a bunch of techs at one point and have gone down to having zero techs on defense, it looks like. So they're going to have to kind of maybe play some maneuvering to get some techs back. Looks like red has too many techs, and they're all down in the red base right now. So looks like the two defenders, one has amp, one has doc. Yowza said he wants to play on D. Like I said, Yowza is a very good railer. I don't know if I said that at all, but he is a very good railer. He plays very well when he doesn't have to move around a lot. I guess he doesn't have the best movement available. Blackberry has a flag. Got railed once, got railed twice. Got hit again. His teammate's able to kill everybody. Looks like Twitch was able to kill everybody, grab the flag, and get the cap. So 7-2, 3 minutes left to play. Surprisingly, you haven't seen a lot. Sorry, I haven't seen a lot from Quad in this map. I kind of thought that Quad would be a bigger role in this map than what it has been. I believe that's because if you have amp at home and Quad tries to rush in, it's not like you have power shield or anything else. You know, you don't even have red armor in this map, and so even if you have doc, you can only really survive two rails by amp. If there's two people on defense and you're trying to attack, then you know you could be up shit creek without a paddle. You know, eat a rocket from amp and then a couple grenades or something by somebody else, and you're dead. Next thing you know, doesn't matter if you have quad or not. So, like I said, I kind of thought quad would be a bigger role in this map, but looking on it, you know, more in depth, I guess it doesn't surprise me that much. So, chasing Rusty, looks like he might be playing a little bit of outer D, maybe a little bit of middle. Maybe a little bit of whatever he kind of feels at this point in time. So looks like there's a lot of blue players in the blue base. Again, it doesn't look like they have any techs. We're chasing Cake at this point. I haven't seen much of Cake, I guess, so far this map. Not to say that he hasn't been doing anything. It just looks like Dash hasn't been really following him that much. So he's in base right now. 50 seconds left to play. I don't really think that... Blue is going to be able to turn this one around. Looks like they're still trying for quad. They do get quad. Whether or not they're going to be able to do anything with it and whether or not that's going to matter. So, yeah, 30 seconds left to play. Not really much left to talk about. I can go over kind of maybe what was good and bad. Looks like Twitch kind of had control of the blue base the whole time. Sorry, the red base the whole time. Didn't let many people in or out. It looks like he had help on defense, which turned out to be better than trying to grab quad. So hopefully that's a lesson learned for, you know, other teams that are going to be playing these maps. Every team does play this map at least once, if not twice. And so it's definitely something to keep in mind. So final tally for both teams. Looks like, no surprise, Twitch is first place on his team. Elka's first place on his team. I don't know what else to tell you other than Legend's team is slated to win this whole thing, and looks like they got beat out by Twitch's team. So I would like to say it's a good game, but it doesn't look like it was that close, I guess. So thanks for watching.